So in last session, we actually built a small app and we learned how to create objects, fields, apps and tabs. This is what we have done, right? In last session, we built a small recruitment manager app with the help of our recruitment manager app. Now, we are today going to do a few more things. We are going to learn about a few more functionalities. But before you start talking about other stuff, let's just understand a small concept here. Now you know how to create an object, you know how to create a field, you know how to create an app, you know how to create a tab. Right? It's not always that you will be building a new app like this one. Okay, this was just an example to show you so that you understand a complete perspective of how an app is built. But it's not going to be always that you will be working or creating an app like this. Okay, sometimes it's just going to be. Sometimes it's just going to be, a small thing that needs to be created. Okay, sometimes customization will be to the level of just adding a field to a certain object. Okay. Or just adding one object into the entire structure, right? So that's where we are basically going to go and do the customization. So we'll have to identify that this is what I need to do, and you just go and do that particular thing. Let's say I'm pretty much okay with whatever sales app has been given by Salesforce. I just need to add one object here. Okay. Apart from these campaigns, leads, accounts and all these things, I do a product demo at the client location. Let's say for my business, there's a requirement that I would go and do a product demonstration at the client location. Okay. My company wants me to create a table or object for product demonstration. That can be just one single object. So I don't have to build an app and everything. All that I need is, I just need to build a single object called product demonstration, create a tab for that and fit that tab somewhere here. Okay, fit the tab somewhere here. That's it. That's what we have to do. Got it? So that product demo thing can be done from here. All that you need to do is just go to setup, create object, create the object from here, put the fields which are required, create a tab, and then just decide where exactly you want to fit that tab in the sales app. Alright. Okay. Another requirement can be as small as adding a field. So let's say I have accounts, and in accounts, I just want to add one more field, category, account category. Okay. Category A, B, C, something like that. I just want to add that. How will I do that? All that I need to do is just go ahead and add a category to this, which is a category is a field. So you have to go ahead and add a field. But account is a standard object, so you will not find it in the setup create. Under setup create objects, you will only see the custom objects. Custom objects are the objects that you have created. All right. So here only the objects that you have created are available. Where do you access the objects which are already there? Those objects will be available under customize. Okay, go to customize accounts, and under accounts click on fields. This is where your account fields are going to be available. Right. So this is where our account fields are available. Here a lot of standard fields are there. I want to create one more field, like just go to custom fields, click on new. Same way, the way you create a field in a custom object, same way you are going to create a field here also. Just have to go to account fields, click on this, whatever field you want to create. Got it? So your customization can be as small as creating a field in an object. It can be adding an additional object. It can be adding one or two tabs. All right. Okay. So that's something which I wanted you to understand, that these components, whatever you have learned to create these components. These components are to be used, you know, wherever you want. So it's not always that you will be creating an application. You just have to identify the requirement. If the requirement is just to create a field, you will just go ahead and create a field. If the requirement is to create an object, you will just create an object. Correct? Okay. Now, talking about a few more things apart from what we have done, let's understand a few more concepts. First concept is a relationship that we are going to talk today. The relationship is basically the connect between two objects. You might have seen that there is a relationship required between two objects in a lot of situations, in a lot of cases. In our example that we were just doing, in that example, we had a relationship between job application was related to consultant or sorry, applicant, and application was also related to job opening. Correct? So the connection between two objects is basically called the relationship. How do we create this relationship? There's one object, there's another object, there's a relationship between them. How do we create this relationship? To create the relationship, first thing that you have to do is you have to figure out which is the parent and which is the child. There are two objects. You have to figure out which one is parent and which one is child. Okay? Now think about it and tell me, if there is a relationship between job application and applicant, which one do you think is parent and which one is child? There's a table in which you have listed all the job applicants. There's another table where you have listed all the job applications. Which one is parent and which one is child?
Application is parent, applicant is the child.
Applicant is the child?
Yes.
How? Why do you think so?
Because when you can have an applicant will apply an application, right? So under application, you normally get a lot of applicants.
Or the other way around.
Maybe the other way around.
Right. So
applicants and application.
Yes. So which is parent?
Applicant.
Applicant is parent, application is child. One applicant can make multiple applications, job applications. So pretty simple, right? So if one applicant can make multiple applications, applicant is parent, application is a child. So you have to identify wherever there is a relationship required. First thing that you have to do is you just have to ask yourself a question, which is a parent, which is a child. And it's very simple to identify. Right? It's not something very difficult. You just have to see if one applicant is connected to multiple applications, then applicant is definitely parent. It has multiple child. Now, to create the relationship, first thing, First thing, identify parent and child. Then you have to create a relationship. How do we create the relationship? We create a relationship with the help of a relationship field. So you create a relationship field on child object. So all that you have to do is you just have to go ahead and create a relationship field on the child object. You don't have to create the relationship field on the parent. You have to create the relationship field on the child object. As simple as that. Alright. So relationship field always needs to be created on the child object. And there's a field type relationship field you must have seen while creating fields. You just have to go ahead and create a relationship field on the child object. Okay. This is how simple it is. Now, if I go to this particular thing, okay, I don't have those objects here. Let me just quickly create an object. Create objects. Manifest on an object. So first of all, we should be creating the parent object. Applicant. Firstly, we should be creating the parent object. Call it applicants. And then create the child object application. Okay. Now you identify which is the parent, which is the child. And then go ahead and create the relationship field on the child object. So as we just talked about it, application is the child object. So I have to create the relationship on the child object. So just go to the child object, go to custom field, click on new and create the relationship field. In the relationship field, you have the option of choosing a lookup relationship or a master detail relationship. Okay. You have the option of selecting a lookup or a master detail relationship. Lookup relationship is the generic kind of a relationship which is very, very common. Master detail relationship is a special kind of relationship, right? So right now we are not going to get into the master detail relationship thing. For now, just use the lookup relationship till the time you guys start understanding relationships a little better. And then, you know, you can look into the special thing. So basically master detail relationship has a few additional functionalities. So you will be able to understand this when you are a little more familiar with the Salesforce data and the relationships. So for now, we will just use the generic lookup relationship. That's it. Related to which object? Related to the applicant object. Click on next. Some of you might have done this as yesterday's assignment, just to make sure that we all are on the same page. This is how the relationship will be created. Right. Anytime two objects are related, just figure out which is the parent, which is the child, go to the child object, create the relationship field, and your relationship will be ready. Alright. Okay. So this was a simple relationship. Applicant and application. This was a simple relationship. Now think about another scenario. I have an object, job openings. I have another object, applicants. Okay, what kind of a relationship do you think these two objects are? Which is parent, which is child? Because I have to, you know, relate these two things. There's a job opening, and then there is, I have a pool of job opening, and I have a pool of people who are applying for the jobs. I need to relate it somewhere just to understand who applied for which job, correct? That needs to be done. Which is parent, which is child?
So basically one job opening will have many applicants, so one to many relationship, so job opening would be the primary or the parent, applicants would be the
child.
Child.
Okay, good. But don't you think the same applicant can apply for multiple jobs as well? If I apply for a job and then I don't get selected, then I'll apply for next job also.
Yeah, vice versa. Yeah.
Then,
so if there are multiple job openings, then the and multiple applicants, then it's many to many.
Correct.
Yes. So this is a situation where you cannot figure out that this is parent, this is child. You cannot say that. This is basically called a many to many relationship. So normal relationship is parent child relationship, one to many. That's pretty simple. You just go to the child object and create the field relationship field. Your job is done. So the situation like this is called a many-to-many relationship. How do we achieve this?
Is this also called a referential integrity?
I don't know, what is the referential integrity? Sorry.
Like in the data model where we have this many-to-many relationships where we can have one as child and one as parent, vice versa. Is that something called referential, like both can reference to each other anytime?
Right, similar to that, but still let's talk in the terminologies that we all understand, and then you can relate it to your own terminology, set of terminologies that you might have used
right, right.
for previous technology.
Right. Okay.
So this is a many-to-many kind of a relationship. So here what is happening? The challenge is that where do I go and create the relationship field? Many to many it is there, we understand concept wise it's fine. The question for you is where do I go and create the relationship field? Okay, no? Because I'm not able to identify the child. None of them is a child. Then what do I do? How do you deal with this situation? So it's pretty simple. What we'll do is, because both of them are not child, so one is, let's say your job openings, one is your applicants, right? And there's a many-to-many relationship. Where exactly we have to create the field? We have to, in this case, we have to create a junction object. Create a third object, okay? So concept wise we have understood, but how do we put it in the data structure? You have to create a third object which will be called a junction object. You have to connect this object here. We have to connect this object here. So there will not be a direct connection between these two objects, but they will be connected through the junction object. And this junction object is going to be the child of both of them. Common child. Correct? So there will be a one-to-many relationship from here to here, and there will be a one-to-many relationship from here to here. Are we clear on this? So all that you have to do is, you just have to go ahead and create a junction object, and in that junction object you have to create, you have to make this junction object as child of both these objects. So you will create a lookup field for jobs, you will create a lookup field for applicants. And through this junction object, job and applicants are going to be connected. That's basically the many-to-many relationship. And exactly that's what we are doing here in our recruitment manager app. That's what we have done. That's what we have done here. So we talked about one object called job. Okay, there were a few fields, let's say title, salary. Okay. And we talked about another object called applicants. And then I had to create this junction object. The application. So in this case, application is acting as a junction object. So application is a child of applicant, as we just did. Application is going to be a child of job also. Which job is being applied for in that application, correct? In application, let's say you have the date of application, you have which job is being applied for, which applicant has applied. So this is lookup. This is also lookup. Clear? This is how simple it is. So applicant application connection and job and application connection. That's a junction object. This is how you basically make a many to many relationship. Clear on it? Let me know if there is any doubt or question.
I have a doubt.
Yep.
When you talk about the junction object, you create the application function object first, and then you start creating the field, right? That's what you mean, lookup field.
You'll have to create the object first, right? You cannot create fields before creating the object. Junction object is also an object. I mean, just concept-wise, name of that is junction because it's a child, common child of these two objects. It's just an object. You have to create the object. And you have to create a relationship field on this object for both the objects.
Is junction object always a standard, always a custom object?
It has to be.
Can be a standard.
It has to be a custom object because you are creating it. Okay. If you want to use one of the standard objects as a junction object, you can do that as well. You don't have, you know, it does not have to be a custom object only. If you want to use one of the existing objects as a junction object, you can do that. All that you have to do is just go to that object, create a lookup field. Let's say for application, instead of application, if you take any standard object and connect that standard object with this and this, it becomes a junction object.
Okay.
Correct? So this is basically the concept of many-to-many relationship. So whenever you have this many-to-many relationship kind of a concept, you're not able to figure out which is parent, which is child. You understand this is a many-to-many relationship. Just look into the junction object concept and you will be able to set up the relationships, right? And we already have that in our recruitment manager app. All right. So sometimes you might be, you know, ready with the data structure, but you might not have figured out that this is a junction object. Like yesterday, you were not aware that this is actually a junction object. All right. Now the next is field dependency. The next concept is field dependency. What is a field dependency? Field dependency basically is the concept of making one field dependent on the other field.
Right.
So this usually works good with pick lists. Let's say I have country field, and then I have a city field. Let's say I have two countries listed, US, India. I have in the city field, I have four cities listed. Right. So this way you can have, you know, 10, 20 countries, and you can have, let's say, 100, 200 cities. Now you don't want your users to actually, you know, go through and browse all the cities every time. You just want to make sure that based on what country the user selects, you should only see the cities of that country. Because now it's just two countries and three cities or four cities, it's absolutely okay. Easy for you. But just imagine if there were, like, you know, 10 countries that the, you know, company is dealing in, and there are, say, 100, 200 cities which are listed. So it becomes very difficult for the end user to, you know, browse through that in a pick list. So there we will need a field dependency. So let's do a field dependency and see how it works. Create an app for this. Right, created an app and open manager. Let me bring these tabs into this. Right. So we have created the app. Now let's say for applicant I have a field country and city. Right. Now let me go to the applicant. There are two fields, country and city. Mm-hmm. both of them are going to be thickest. Is also going to be a quick list. Two quick lists I've created. Now, if you try to enter it, record into applicant, you will see that these fields are available, country and city. Right? But no matter which country you select, you still get to see the entire list of cities. This is what we don't want. I've selected India, so I should only see Delhi and Mumbai, the Indian cities. I select US, I should only see US cities. Right? But right now it's showing me a list of all the cities, no matter. It is now not, city field is not dependent on the country field. And that's what we have to do. We just have to make the city field dependent on the country field. So very simple, you just have to go to this applicant object. Just go to setup, create object. Right, we will set up create object, and under this you have to go to applicant object, and just beside the option of creating a new field you will find this button called field dependencies. So field dependencies will be defined from here. Right, just click on field dependencies, say new field dependency. Select your controlling field and dependent field. Your controlling field will be country and the dependent field is city. City is the field which is dependent, right? And it's dependent on the country. Scroll down and click on continue. That's it. Now you have the option of choosing which all cities should appear under which country. So under India, you want to show Delhi and Mumbai. You can press Control and do multiple selections. It is written. And under US, you can select SF and NYC. Now include these values. That's it. So Delhi and Mumbai have been included under India, SF and NYC have been included under US. Alright, that's it. Save it. Now if you go to the applicant object, try to enter a new record. You'll see under country India, you have Delhi and Mumbai. In the country US, we have SF. Alright, field dependency concept is clear. I will depend on this. Any question, any doubt with the field dependency thing? Okay. The next thing that we will be talking about is a lookup builder. Alright. The next concept is a lookup filter. What is a lookup filter? Lookup filter is basically a filter that you want to put on the while doing a lookup of the record. The lookup field allows you to pick a record from other object, right? The relationship field basically. So in that, if you want to put a filter, only records which meet this criteria should be allowed to be selected. Correct? That's the lookup filter. Okay. Right. So how do you define a lookup filter? This applicant and application case. So let's say in application also, I have a field called location. Okay, just for you guys to understand the lookup filter. Let's say there's a field called location in the application. Okay, which location is the application being made in, and the applicant that you select for the application, the consultant that you are selecting for the application, city of that consultant and the location has to be same. Okay, so under application I have a field location, and under the applicant I have a field called city. I want to define a lookup filter so that only applicants from the city which are same as location of the application can apply. Okay. Anyone who is from a different city which is not same as the location of the application cannot apply for that, or cannot put an application. So that's what my criteria is. Let's say. Right. Now, so I'll need to go ahead and create a location field in application. Let's go to setup, create objects, and go to application. Create a new field. I can make it request again. Right, so I have a field called location and applicant on the application object, your application object. Now I want to define a lookup filter saying that only allow the applicants who belong to the same city as the location of the application they should be able to put an application, right? Now this lookup filter needs to be put where? On which object? On the child object, obviously, because the lookup field is on the child object. Which is the child object? Application is the child object. Lookup field is also here, right? So just go ahead, edit the lookup field. So lookup filter has to be put on the lookup field itself. Go to the lookup field which you have created. Go to show filter settings. And this is where you have the option of putting the criteria. What is your criteria? Your criteria is that applicant city has to be applicant city should be equal to field. Which field? Location field. So applicant city should always be equal to application location. That's basically the criteria that we have put. Right. Now this is a lookup filter. Save the lookup field. The criteria has been saved. Now let me just create a couple of applicants. Let's say applicant one is location Delhi, say. This is another applicant. Okay, so I've listed two applicants here. One is Jeep, one is Mukesh. One is from Delhi, one is from here. Now while I'm entering a job application, new job application, location of the application is, let's say, Delhi. Now only the applicants from Delhi will be, you will be able to select only applicants from Delhi. Okay. See, this depends on your location. It is also mentioned here. So because location is Delhi, only applicants from Delhi can apply. Okay. Only Jeet Singh was available. Right. But if we change it to New York City, then Venkat will be available because he is the one who is available in that particular location. Correct. So this way you can define lookup filter to control things, right? That's how a lookup filter will control things. You want to put certain filter criteria on the lookup, you can do this. So this is also kind of field dependency, but this is something which you cannot define using the field dependency concept, but you will do this using the lookup filter. Let me know if anyone has a question on this lookup filter concept.
I have one. What I understand, the difference between lookup filter and the field dependency is that field dependency can be controlled within an object, and lookup filter is for multiple objects, right?
Yeah, obviously, because lookup concept itself is of multiple objects, right? Lookup, wherever lookup is coming, it's related to the other object.
So if it is one single object, then field dependency is the better option to use, right?
Field dependency works with your quick list. Lookup filter works with your lookup values.
Lookup
field values. So, you know, the straight answer would be that if you are dealing with it, and apart from these two options, you don't have dependency concept anywhere else. Because when there is a text being written or a number being entered, there is no concept of dependencies and all. So, the concept will be applicable only in case of a pick list and a lookup. So if you're dealing with pick list, then field dependency. If you're dealing with a lookup field, then lookup filter. Correct? More or less, they are doing the same job, but different options. So while you define a lookup field, you have the option. Now this location thing, while we created a location field here, because I do not have a job object, but if think about it, if you have a job opening object and the location field is on the job, so you could have actually selected the location from there also. And you don't have to have this location field here itself. You could have actually validated it with the location of the job. So that too is an option. Right.
Right.
Anyone, any questions? No, we are good. Okay. So now coming back to our recruitment manager app, right? So we have seen a lot of things. We have seen how we create small components, how we can actually enhance the functionalities, and we will continue to see how we can enhance the page layouts, user interfaces, how we can actually put logics into our application. So we are going to learn a lot of other stuff to improve the application. But what I would want you guys to do is, I would want you all to extend the functionalities of this particular app, the recruitment manager app, a little. So what else do you think can be added into this? And that's something which is going to be an assignment for you guys today. So what else do you think can be added? A recruitment manager app, what else do you think it should have? We have jobs listed, we have applicants listed, we have applications listed. Apart from that,
interview status,
an object for interviews. Okay, apart from that, interview is being taken. Apart from that, anything else? No?
Yeah, rounds for interviews.
So they will be tracked in the interviews, right? Interview object. Okay. Any offers which are being made? So once the interview and the person is through, you make an offer. So which offer was made, to whom, what was the salary offered, what is the last day of acceptance of that offer, what is the status of the offer, that sort of thing. So yeah, apart from this, do you think anything else would be required here? These two objects, all right? So what I would want you guys to do is go back and try and add 2-3 more objects into this, because this is the time when you can actually spend on thinking about the data structure, right? Again, as we proceed in the course, we are going to do so many options and all that stuff. You might not have time available always for doing the, thinking about the data structure. What can I bring? Where should I have a pick list? Where should I have a lookup field? Where should I have a lookup filter? So try to think about these things. Try to bring in these things. And for everything, you should be, considering different factors, whether I need a text field here or a pick list, what will be good. Okay, this will actually help you figure out and understand the field data types also a little better. Like when I say city, applicant city, I could have made it a text field also, right? Why do we make it a pick list? This can be a text field also, right? Can anyone tell me what
it is? There can be typo errors.
Sorry?
There can be typo errors while typing it.
Yes.
Right?
there will be typing errors and stuff like that, and it will become difficult for you to do any sort of reporting then. You know, there will be too many values for the same city, right? So this phase, when you consider these things, when you start thinking, why I'm actually asking you to think a little on the data structure side, because when you start thinking, when you start actually focusing a little on that, you get a lot of answered questions which, you know, which you might not even think of if you are not thinking on these, right? So that's the reason why I would want you to spend a little more time, try to extend this recruitment manager. We will come back to this recruitment manager app after a few more sessions. So for a few more sessions, we are going to get into a few more topics, controlling the permissions and all that stuff. But in the background, I want you guys to spend some time on this recruitment manager app every day. All right? Not in the session, but you should yourself keep doing it. All right? Keep on building this app. And after a few sessions, I'll again check back with you what is your progress, where exactly you want it right now in terms of your app. Right. So this is like a mini project, as I told you. This is a small project for you, guys, and you should keep continue to work on it.